Hello, Joe.
Turn right, left.
Lynette. Pat must be Lynette with skin colour like that.
I've got hair. Yeah,
No. Please welcome your top table guests. If they'll get a move on, can and you can list everybody down as doing their bit for it, but
the best thing was Chris Kirby, what a good bit of marketing. We had a sort of vote on the night of what we would do, so from Gladiators to Toy Story, and he really put in heart and soul into it. John as normal for tonight and everything that John does. Chris, Mr. Dennis there, he was all filthy looks. Not his look, not like a bloody darling. He does a lot of work behind the scenes to get those presents. I mean, the best thing with Stuart is he'll ring it up and say, can you just do an audit of the present state? And I say, all right then. He said, can you do it now? I said, yeah, well, I'll ring you back. Well, no, I'm in Amsterdam Airport. Can you just tell me how many we've got? he does ring me from all over the world, worrying about leaving on his travels.
Is he ringing?
We're all attending tonight. I hope I'm not giving you too much of a shock. I'm meant to prompt Keith now.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, Keith.
I love you. Oh,
go on, Keith. Go on.
Hey, true table fashion, Mr. T.
Well organised.
We've got them towers here. Keith organises everything. Oh, it's simple, I love it all at home. It's a very good spirit, it's a funny news at all.
Somebody hit the ground.
They started off by saying something about lifetime guests, but they're not present around the house. But Dave had a very successful year as chairman of 41 Books. And more recently, he's had a much more successful year as chairman of Round Table. He's the only person who's ever been chairman. Now he's done a really good speech tonight, and of course there's not really very much left to say. But I have got some notes. Waistline. It's a barometer of good fellowship in Richmond Roundtable. And I found tonight, when I was getting dressed, that over the last 12 months, I couldn't possibly manage to get DJ. So this speaks volumes for Dave's chair and the first one. Because everybody who's in it has had a really fantastic time. And I think the only other thing that's ever remembered.
Thank you.
Ed's money has always been a bit of a mystery. So here we are for Roger Cook to try and find out and solve that mystery. Roger.
Hello, good morning. We've got some questions that we wanted to go and approach Mr. Cook. We're just outside Mr. Dave Phillips, Mr. Mayor-elect Dave Phillips. He's going to ask him a few questions on the dubious past that he started his business. We understand that we are now looking for some 2.5 million missing bricks.
I'm afraid Dave's unavailable for comment.
We're looking for some 2.5 million missing
bricks.
Well, the address is www.bobthebuilder.com.
See you there.
Then Keith had a think, and he thought we ought to take off all the handles and the things that hold the candles. But it did no good, well I never thought it would. Right, said Dave, have to take the feet off, get them feet off, wouldn't take them home. Took its feet off, even with the seat off, should have got us somewhere. Let's have another cup of tea, and we said, right-o. Right, said Dave, have to take the door off, leave more space to shift the so-and-so. Had our twinges, taking off the hinges, and it got us nowhere, and so we had a cup of tea.
You're on with it.
Right, said Dave, have to take the ball down the wall, he's got out to go. Took the wall down, even with the hole down, we was getting nowhere, and so we had a cup of tea. If we remove So we all had another cup of tea and then we went home.
Now our sixth day, you know, the problem is we'll have to leave it standing. The trouble is, you see, with Dave, is it's too hasty. And you get nowhere if you're too hasty. Thank you, Jenny.
Whee!
Hold
on again.
You've
all heard of the Oscars. Being an upstanding member of Round Table, we feel deserves an Oscar. From this point, I'd also like to ask Lynette to come forward. Now, this Oscar, although it's solid gold, it's modelled on Dave perfectly. So Dave tells us, and we want to ask Lynette whether this is the case. So, Lynette, is this Dave?
No!